Well, good morning. Merry Christmas, everybody. Good morning. It's great to see everybody here this morning. And we hope that God's spirit of love, hope, joy, and peace surrounds you on this special Christmas morning. And as we await Christ's final return, which we look forward to, we pray that everyone is spreading the good news of Jesus to those they encounter. Let's listen to our prelude this morning as we center our thoughts on our worship today. Today we celebrate the birth of our Savior Jesus Christ. The prophet Zechariah foretold the coming of the promised King who would bring salvation to his people when he said, "Rejoice greatly, O daughter of Zion. Shout aloud, O daughter of Jerusalem. Behold, your King is coming to you. Righteous and having salvation is he."
Jesus, you are our righteous King. Through your birth, life, death, resurrection, you have brought to us the gift of salvation.
The name we love, the name of Jesus, means God saves or salvation. An angel told Joseph to take Mary as his wife and said, "She will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save the people from their sins." The Apostle Peter, on trial for preaching the good news about Jesus, said, "There is salvation in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven given among men by which we must be saved."
Jesus, you alone are the way of salvation.
The Apostle Paul wrote about Jesus' saving work, and being found in human form, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God has highly exalted him and bestowed on him the name that is above every name.
So that at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, in heaven
and on earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God. Amen. Let's join in our opening hymn this morning. It's number 240 in the hymnal. The words are on the screen. "Hark, the herald angels sing."
Thank you.
join in the unison prayer. Almighty God, on this joyful day, we offer our thanks and praise for the gift of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. The Holy Child of Bethlehem was born among us to bring us salvation through his humble birth, his perfect life, and his suffering, death, and resurrection. We confess Jesus as Lord, and we love his holy name, the name by which we are saved. As we celebrate his birth, help us to walk in love as our Lord walked. In the power of the Holy Spirit, let us share with others the good news of salvation through faith in Jesus. Hear our prayers and accept our praise in his holy name. You may be seated. Today's just a worship opportunity for us to sing praises to God through our hymns and also to hear his word. And our first lesson today is from Genesis chapter 3, beginning at verse 8. When the cool evening breezes were blowing, the man and his wife heard the Lord God walking about in the garden. So they hid from the Lord God among the trees. And then the Lord God called to the man, "Where are you?" And he replied, "I heard you walking in the garden, so I hid. I was afraid because I was naked." "Who told you you were naked?" the Lord God asked. "Have you eaten from the tree whose fruit I commanded you not to eat?" And the man replied, "The woman who gave me the fruit, and I ate it." And then the Lord God asked the woman, "What have you done?" "The serpent deceived me," she replied. "That's why I ate it." And then the Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, you are cursed more than all animals, domestic and wild. You will crawl on your belly, groveling in the dust as long as you live. And I will cause hostility between you and the woman, between your offspring and her offspring. He will strike your head, and you will strike his heel." And to the man he said, "Since you listened to your wife and ate from the tree whose fruit I commanded you not to eat, the ground is cursed because of you. All your life you will struggle to scratch a living from it. It will grow thorns and thistles for you, though you will eat of its grains. And by the sweat of your brow will you have food to eat until you return to the ground from which you were made. For you were made from dust, and to dust you will return." And our response for that this morning is to sing hymn number 237, "Sing Me Now of Christians, Christmas, the First Verse." "Because you have obeyed me and have not withheld even your son, your only son, I swear by my own name that I will certainly bless you. I will multiply your descendants beyond number, like the stars in the sky and the sands on the seashore. Your descendants will conquer the cities of their enemies, and through your descendants all the nations of the earth will be blessed, all because you obeyed me." And our response to that this morning is to sing, "O Come, O Come, Emmanuel," the first and the fourth verse.
verse 2.
The people who walk in darkness will see a great light. For those who live in a land of deep darkness, a light will shine. For a child is born to us, a son is given, and the government will rest on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His government and its peace will never end, and he will rule with fairness and justice from the throne of his ancestor David for all eternity. The passionate commitment of the Lord of the Heaven's armies will make this happen. And our response is through a video from Chris Todd this morning called His Name is Wonderful. Chapter 11, beginning at verse 1. Out of the stump of David's family will grow a shoot, yes, a new branch bearing fruit from the old root. And the Spirit of the Lord will rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. And he will delight in obeying the Lord. He will not judge by appearance, nor make decision based on hearsay. He will give justice to the poor and make fair decisions for the exploited. In that day, the wolf and the lamb will live together. The leopard will lie down with the baby goat, and the calf and the yearling will be safe with the lion, and a little child will lead them all. The cow will graze near the bear, the cub and the calf will lie down together. The lion will eat hay like a cow. The baby will play safely near the hole of a cobra. Yes, a little child will put its hand in a nest of deadly snakes without harm. Nothing will hurt or destroy it in all my holy mountain, for as the waters fill the sea, so the earth will be filled with people who know the Lord. And our response to this morning is to sing hymn number 230, O Little Town of Bethlehem. When the leaves come out, you know without being told that summer is near. In the same way, when you see all these things taking place, you can know that the kingdom of God is near. I tell you the truth, this generation will not pass from the scene until all these things have taken place. Heaven and earth will disappear, but my words will never disappear. Watch out. Don't let your hearts be dulled by carousing and drunkenness and the worries of this life. Don't let that day catch you unaware like a trap, for that day will come upon everyone living on the earth. The crowds will gather at the temple early each morning to hear him. And our response to this reading today is singing Come Thou Long Expected Jesus, hymn number 196. Syria. All returned to their own ancestral towns to register for this census. And because Joseph was a descendant of King David, he had to go to Bethlehem in Judea, David's ancient home. He traveled there from the village of Nazareth in Galilee. And he took with him Mary, to whom he was engaged, who was now expecting a child. And while they were there, the time came for her baby to be born. And she gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him snugly in strips of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no lodging available for them. And now we'll respond with the first Noel, the first verse.
Thank you.
is from Luke chapter 2, beginning with verse 8. And that night there were shepherds staying in the fields nearby, guarding their flocks of sheep. And suddenly an angel of the Lord appeared among them, and the radiance of God's glory surrounded them. They were terrified, but the angel reassured them. "Don't be afraid," he said. "I bring you good news that will bring great joy to all people. The Savior, yes, the Messiah, the Lord, has been born today in Bethlehem, the city of David. And you will recognize him by this sign. You will find a baby wrapped snugly in strips of cloth lying in the manger." And suddenly the angel was joined by a vast host of others, the armies of heaven, praising God, saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and peace on earth to those whom God has pleased." When the angels had returned to heaven, the shepherds said to each other, "Let's go to Bethlehem. Let's see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." And they hurried to the village and found Mary and Joseph, and there was the baby lying in the manger. And our response to this is singing verse 2 of the first Noel. Stationed abroad or here in the United States that aren't able to make it home, and all those the first responders that are working today as well. We just ask God's blessing upon all of them and give them the peace and joy that come with this season as well. Other joys and concerns?
It's a joy to see the sunshine this morning.
It was a joy to see the sunshine this morning. That was really good, yes.
He
Yep, Jesus told us to forgive.
Christ at the cross, he shed his blood, but he washed all our sins away in the ocean.
That's right. He washed all our sins, so we are loved and forgiven children.
Now we're sin free.
Now we're sin free. You're right. He died for all of us. Other joys and concerns today. Shall we go to the Lord in prayer? Gracious and loving God, we just thank you once again for bringing the sunshine and the light into this world. And Lord, we thank you for this beautiful sunshine to remind us of the light of Christ that came to all of us. And Father, we just ask your blessing upon all those that are homeless and struggling today. May they find peace and joy and warmth and a warm meal somewhere for them. And Father, for those that are recovering from surgeries and treatments and other maladies and just have colds and not feeling well, Lord, give them your comfort and your grace and peace today. Help them to recover, and we just thank you for medical staff and doctors, nurses, and all those technicians and all those scientists that help come up with treatments and surgeries and know how to treat various maladies. And so, Lord, we just give you thanks and praise for those as well. And Father, we just thank you also for the gift of travel and being able to be with family and enjoying this holiday season. And Lord, for all those that are traveling, just grant them your mercy and let them get to their destination. And for all those that were unable to make it home to family and friends. Lord, grant them your peace. Give them the joy that only you can give that surpasses all of our human understanding. We ask all these things in the precious name of our Savior Jesus, as we join in the prayer which he taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And our final lesson is from John chapter 1, beginning with verse 1. In the beginning, the Word already existed, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He existed in the beginning with God, and God created everything through him, and nothing was created except through him. And the Word gave life to everything that was created, and his life brought light to everyone. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness can never extinguish it. God sent a man, John the Baptist, to tell about the light so everyone might believe because of his testimony. And John himself was not the light. He was simply a witness to tell about the light. The one who is the true light, who gives light to everyone, was coming into the world. And he came into the very world which he created. But the world didn't recognize him. He came to his own people, and even they rejected him. But to all who believed him and accepted him, he gave the right to become children of God. They are reborn, not with a physical birth resulting from human passion or plan, but a birth that comes from God. So the Word became human and made his home among us. He was full of unfailing love and faithfulness. And we have seen his glory, the glory of the Father's one and only Son. This is the Word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. And let's sing our closing hymn and stand if you are able in posture and spirit as we sing Joy to the World. Thank you. blessing for us. May the true light of the world, Jesus Christ, live and reign in your hearts always. And may you pass that joy, peace, hope, and love to everyone you meet.